Take 16-inch wood skewers. Start by gluing wood skewers around the inner circumference of one craft hoop. Remove every other skewer to allow for even spacing and add a second hoop to the center of the skewers. Gather all the pointy ends of the skewers and fit them into a 3-inch macrame ring and hot glue in place to secure. Take twine, lace, and ribbon and add it to mask any seams or imperfections from hot gluing. Take a plug-in light fixture kit and thread it through the center of the top of the macrame loop. There you have it, a cheap way to create your own easy, modern DIY pendant light for your home for less than $20.
Before painting, I cleaned the chandelier from top to bottom. I turned off the electricity from the electrical panel in the garage, and I stood on a very sturdy ladder to gently apply the paint. Next, I placed the globes in the sink to wash them. I taped off the top and the inside of the globe. I lightly applied a semi-gloss paint to the outside of the globes. I then buffed away the residue left behind by the spray paint. I placed the globe on a sheet of paper. I drew a circle. I then cut away the edges of the paper. I folded my circle in half twice, and then I folded it into thirds, three equal parts. I placed the globe back onto the circle, and using those fold lines as a guide, I placed marks on the globe. I used those markings to indicate where I would draw vertical lines. I lightly drew all of the horizontal lines, and then I began to lightly apply the paint as a primer coat. Applied several other coats thereafter. I lightly applied the Mod Podge sealer. It dries in minutes. I hope this project inspires you to add a little whimsy to an old chandelier.
Run to Dollar Tree and pick up one large plastic bowl. Use a palette knife and drywall spackle to apply to the exterior of the bowl. Create a hole in the bottom of the bowl in the size of a light socket. Finish spackling around the hole. Add Dixie Belle's Slick and Stick to the inside of the bowl with a paintbrush. Take Modern Masters metallic gold paint, at least two layers. Sand the surface of the spackled exterior. Take Rub and Buff and buff into the surface of the bowl interior. Take a hanging light kit from Amazon, add a light bulb of choice, hang in place, and plug in. Create your own modern pendant light for less than $15.
These cute containers came from the Dollar Tree to attach the pink to the purple. I'm gonna go ahead and place the adhesive about right in there. Slide together, very firm hold. Pop it right in the middle there.
I've got a large adhesive strip and I'm just going to put it on the back side of my sconces, and then I'm going to attach it to the wall.
I think it turned out super cute and not too bad for only $15.
Grab some hot glue and put a bead of glue along one side of your lampshade, and then add some twine or jute, and we're going to wrap that around the lampshade until we cover the entire thing. After you have all your tassels made, we are going to add these to the bottom of our lampshade. And I decided to hot glue these. You could use a needle and thread and tie them and sew them on the edge, but this worked out perfect. You are going to simply trim off the excess tails. Oh my gosh, I cannot believe that this is from a Walmart lampshade. Literally looks like I got it from Anthropology.
I bought a set of bamboo plates, these LED bulb lights. I'm using two different types of spray paint, and then I'm going to go over the top with a little bit of gold, unscrew this piece, and turn the light on. I'm going to use some double-sided adhesive mounting strips. Then I'm just gonna stick the light bulb to the center of the plate. Picture hanging strips. So I'm just gonna apply one big one to the back and hang it up on my wall. That's it. This was a really easy project to make these gorgeous light fixtures.
I found this basket for a few dollars, so I'm going to use this round drill bit to add the lamp. I just need to thread the cord through the hole. Now that I have my pieces cut, I need to join the two together and use a piece of fusing tape and then hold my hot iron on it, and I can slip the cord right through the middle. I love how pretty this basket looks as a lamp and how easy it was to cover the dark cord.
Go ahead and grab yourself a tomato cage and also grab some wood shims. Grab a scrap board, take the thick end. You're gonna get a nice clean hole, and we're gonna do this to all of our shims. What we're gonna do is take a towel and just dip it in there, make sure it's all covered. Just wipe it on there. The sticky points that go into the ground, we don't need those. It's just gonna snap right off. Now we're gonna grab us some copper wire. We're gonna put that through the shim with the hole in it. Just use it like a twist tie. Go all the way around. Once you get the second layer done, we're going to grab us a solar light from Dollar Tree. Take off that small part on the bottom, the stake. We don't need that. And let it float right in the middle. Now we're going to work on that last circle. And when the night starts to fall, Watch this. That thing is going to light up. And you don't even have to turn it on or off. It works its magic automatically and recharges during the day.
Set an edge of your lampshade against one edge of the wallpaper. Measure in 1/2 inch to 1 inch and mark it by running a pencil where the shade meets the paper. Spray the outside of the lampshade with spray adhesive. Roll the lampshade onto the wallpaper, pressing and smoothing as you go. Apply double-sided tape to the inside lip of the top and bottom of the lampshade. Wrap the overage border of the wallpaper over the edge of the shade and press onto the double stick tape. Take some more tape and apply it to the top and bottom of the lampshade. Take some ribbon in a coordinating color and press half of the width onto the double stick tape and secure on the inside of the shade. Do this for the top and bottom of the shade. Continue the lamp makeover by spray painting the base of your lamp. I hope this inspired you to give a tired and worn out lampshade a stylish makeover.
We are going to start with 7 of these bowls. You're also going to need some E6000. Just basically go around. You're going to place it on top. We're going to do this again. So I'm going to give these a little bit of time to cure. I'm going to be taking my E6000 and I'm going to go around the top of this, stack it on top, and we're going to do this one more time. I am using Dixie Belle Vintage Duck Egg Chalk Paint. So I'm actually going to use E6000 for this step. Line it up. And then we're going to let that sit until it dries. And we are going to trace around the inside of the hole that I created. You actually will not need to paint the underside, just the sides and the top. I'm going to start with the bottom part. Tilt that up. So we are going to take a solar light, placing it over, put the top part of our solar light, and it's going to nestle right in.
Here is my finished DIY cordless solar lamp for my outdoor patio.
So to get started, I am going to take apart the lamp and I'm just going to put some alcohol on the paper towel and wipe down my lamp base. I'm just giving a little light base coat to this. And then I have some all-in-one pre-mixed stucco patch. And I'm just using an old chip brush and I'm just going to coat the entire thing. While that's drying, I'm going to take that really kind of dingy old looking lampshade. I'm using some white chalk paint. That's water that you saw me mist on there. And it just makes the paint kind of flow and cover nicely. I'm gonna let that dry. Then I'm actually gonna do a second coat. I have a medium gray paint here and I've also added a little water to it. I'm just gonna take a regular paintbrush. So I'm just gonna work on getting this whole lamp base covered in this. While that gray is still wet, I'm grabbing some mud by Dixie Belle. I put a glove on to put this part on. It's a lot like spackle. Let that dry for about an hour. And then grab a sanding block and get that all sanded smooth down. And then for even more dimension, I have white chalk paint and then a lighter gray. Little sea sponge here that I'm just getting kind of damp. And I've also misted my paint plate. Now I'm just going to kind of dab around and keep working on this faux finish. And then after I do all that, now I have black and brown paint. Okay, so I'm watering down that paint a little bit. And a push pin. I'm using the tip, the little pin, to add some little dots. Lastly, just to seal in all this, I used a matte clear spray. And I am really, really, really happy with how this came out. It was really fun to do too.